Hey Todd, Dogbreath here. I want to take a minute and go over a setup I did a couple of weeks ago that allowed me to get this coyote. Okay, let's take a look. And I want to show you why I set up the way that we did and the area that we decided to make our stand, why we chose that, and what we were looking for. Now, I will tell you this. We scouted this place earlier in the day. Lots of snow, as you can see. Scouted it early in the day. We saw some fresh tracks, so we decided to go back that evening. I had a partner with me. And what this was a, down here was a real pretty, thick, overgrown fence line with some tall grass and some small trees and brushing through here. Now, the wind was going in this direction. Not a lot of wind, but, maybe 15 mile an hour wind. So what we did, this area up through here, and especially back in this corner, was really thick. So this time of year, with all this snow, you got to find those areas that are more protected, thick pines, thick brushy areas. If you find the rabbits, you usually find the coyotes. So this part of the property was a real thick area. There's a river back a little bit further. So when we moved into our spot, we came in from this way because I think the coyotes are back in here someplace. And once again, I don't blow my scent into the area where I think the coyotes are at. So what happened is I took my partner. He actually climbed a tree and got up into a deer stand up here that he bow hunts out of. Now, the only reason he did that is because this fit into our setup. I won't climb a tree just because it's there. If it works with everything else, that's that's okay. That gives you an advantage. Sometimes you're up, you can see a little bit further. So what this actually was, this was approximately 50 yards across, and this was some corn that the farmer let standing, but a lot of it was blowing down, broken off, so it wasn't really thick in through here. I could see from one side to the other without a problem. Now, so I got my partner up in the tree here, and I went down probably 50, 60 yards and set up in this fence row here. And my thoughts are, this is the thick area. This is where the coyotes are at. The wind's going this way. The coyote's probably going to come in from somewhere down here. I'm the sound. He's going to try to get downwind of the sound. Well, about 20 minutes into the stand, sure enough, a coyote come bolting straight through this way here, about down the center. And it was directly in front of me. It was probably 35 yards out. And what I did, you know my technique, bark and bang. I barked him. He stopped. I shot him at 35 yards with a 3.5-inch magnum, rolled him twice, and, that was the end of the story. So when I set up, I look for the area. I identify where I think the coyotes are. Then I pick a spot that allows that coyote to do what his instincts tell him to do, and that's get downwind of the sound, but stay in cover to do it. Now, this coyote, he thinks he's in cover because he's short, but in reality, he wasn't hit. I could see him plainly coming from all the way over there. And those are the things that I look for in a setup. Allow that coyote to do what its instincts tell him to do, which is circle downwind of the sound, but, and this is a big but, they won't want to leave cover to do it. So look for these kind of things in your setup, and that's a big part of your success is to not only get in there carefully and quietly, but set up in a position where that coyote is actually going to show himself. So that's it for the day. I hope you enjoyed the tip. Stay warm and go shoot some coyotes.